Hello friends, now let us start the problem number 3. Now I will take the another one important example, 6.8 from JBK Das book. A pair of gears 40 and 30 teeth respectively are of 25 degree involute form, addendum equal to 5 mm, module equal to 2.5 mm. If the smaller wheel is the driver and it rotates at a 1500 rpm, find the velocity of sliding at the point of engagement. At the pitch point and at the point of disengagement, the length of contact and length of arc of contact. Okay. Now once again you have to read the problem and you have to write the given data. A pair of gear, so two gears are in mesh each other, so one gear is having 40 teeth and another gear is having 30 teeth. Now bigger one is a gear, nothing, I will take capital T equal to 40, small t equal to 30, that is pinion. 25 degree involute form, nothing but pressure angle is 25 degree. Addendum equal to 5 mm, right? Then module equal to 2.5. If the smaller wheel is the driver, nothing but pinion is the smaller, gear is the bigger. So you can take as pinion is a smaller, that is N1 equal to speed of pinion, N1 equal to 1500 rpm. Now here what he has asked, you need to find velocity of sliding at the point of engagement. Point of engagement nothing but path of approach. At the pitch point, what is the sliding velocity we need to calculate, and the point of disengagement, path of recess, right, disengagement, and then length of path of contact LPC and length of arc of contact LAC we need to find. So one by one we will need to calculate here. Look at that, the solution here. So first we need to understand what is a sliding velocity at the point of engagement. What is the equation for that? Omega 1 plus omega 2 into path of approach. This is the equation you have to use for sliding velocity at the point of engagement, right? Omega 1 plus omega 2 into path of approach. So omega 1 he has given, but we need to find omega 2 and as well as path of approach. We know the equation for path of approach. Then sliding velocity at the point equal to 0, already I have explained. In that point, at the pitch point, the sliding velocity is 0. In that, there is no sliding velocity. So sliding velocity at the point of disengagement, how we can calculate? Omega 1 plus omega 2 into path of recess. Already you know the what is the equation of path of recess, right? So after finding omega 2 value and after finding path of approach, path of recess, we'll get sliding velocity at the point of engagement, sliding velocity at the point of disengagement. Next, length of path of contact. Already I have told that length of path of contact is the summation of path of approach, path of plus path of recess, path of approach plus path of recess. So already whatever you have calculated, just you have to substitute, will get length of path of contact, and length of path of contact already know the equation, length of path of contact divided by cos phi. So we will get length of path of contact. So for finding omega 2, so what you have to do here? Now how we can calculate omega 2? So omega 1 is given, omega 1 is not given, n1 is given, right? So omega 1 plus omega 2, first we need to find omega 1 and after that we need to find omega 2. Okay, the path of approach, path of recess, everything one by one we have to calculate. Now look at that here, this problem. Path of approach, for finding a path of approach, look at that, path of approach, for finding path of approach, what is the equation? R square minus R square cos square phi to the power of 1 by 2 minus R sin phi. He had to required R has to be required, R has to be required, and you have to find. Next, here path of recess again small r square minus r square cos phi to the power of 1 by 2 minus r sin phi. Here also small r as well as small r a, r suppose here has to be required. So we need to find no first. So for that purpose, already know p circle radius of that is capital R, nothing but p circle radius of gear equal to mt by 2. Everything is given, model is given, number of teeth and gear is given. Substitute that value, you will get pitch circle radius of gear R equal to 50 mm. Next, pitch circle radius of pinion smaller one, that is R equal to small r equal to mt by 2. So 2.5 into 30 divided by 2, will get 37.5 mm. Next, addendum circle radius of gear R A equal to, how we can write? Addendum circle radius of gear R A, remember this R A, addendum circle radius of gear R A equal to R plus addendum. So R already you have calculated plus addendum, addendum is given 5 mm. So 50 plus 5 is 55 mm. Now addendum circle radius of pinion, that is small r a equal to r plus addendum, the 5 is given. So 37.55 will get 42.5. So after getting r, capital R, small r, capital R a, small r a, then what you have to do, just substitute the value in path of approach equation, you will get over 10.0.38. Next, path of recess, already you know everything you have, because of already you have calculated, just substitute the value, you will get 9.669 mm. So after getting path of approach and path of recess, next omega 1 equal to, you have to find how we can calculate omega 1. Already you know the general equation, omega equal to 2 pi n by 60. Here omega n is the angular velocity of pinion, 2 pi n1 divided by 60. So 2 pi into n1 already is given in this problem. So 1400, substitute that value divided by 60, you will get 157.07 radians per second. Next, omega 1 you have calculated. Now next we need to find omega 2. How we can calculate? You can calculate using this relation. Remember that, what is that? Angular speed of pinion divided by angular speed of gear, that is omega 1 divided by omega 2 equal to capital T, that is number of teeth and gear divided by number of teeth and pinion. Using this relation or this equation, you can calculate omega 2 value. Omega 1 divided by omega 2, that is angular speed of pinion divided by angular speed of a gear equal to number of teeth and gear divided by number of teeth and pinion. So using omega 1 by omega 2 equal to capital T by small t, because we want here omega 2. How we will get omega 2? Omega values you can substitute 157.07 and t value, that is number of teeth and gear 40, and omega 2 we need to calculate, then number of teeth and pin is 30. Substitute omega 2, you will get 117.8 radians per second. After getting omega 1 omega 2, now sliding velocity at the point of engagement, how we can calculate? Already you know the equation, omega 1 plus omega 2 into path of approach. Just substitute omega 1 values here, omega 2 plus omega 2 value, and into path of approach value is 10.038. you can substitute, you can substitute, right? Okay, you can substitute 10.038, and after you will get 2.76 meter per second for sliding velocity at the point of engagement. So sliding velocity at the point at pitch point is zero, no need to calculate. Next, sliding velocity at the point of disengagement, what is it? How we can calculate? Omega 1 plus omega 2 into path of recess. Omega 1 value is 157.07 plus, and omega 2 value is 117.8 into path of recess. Already you have calculated path of recess 9.669. substitute that value and you can simplify, and you will get 2.658 meter per second or 2657.7 mm per second. Okay, then length of path of contact equal to what? It is a summation of path of approach plus path of recess. Substitute both the values, 10.038 plus 9.669, you will get 19.07 mm. Next, length of arc of contact equal to length of path of contact by cos phi. So length of path of contact is already have calculated 19.707 divided by cos phi, nothing but angle is given 25. So after simplifying, you get 21.744 mm. So like this, remaining problem, same problem, you can also calculate.